we go. I hope you're hungry for nothing.
Boy, I think about it every night and day. I'm addicted, wanna jump inside your love. I wouldn't wanna have it any other way. I'm addicted and I just can't get enough. I'm addicted, like DJ Love.
My brother in Christ, you are scaring the whole.
I really like corn.
What do you like about corn?
It's cold! I'm good for Vietnam! It has to do!
This is totally unacceptable. I'm on my way.
No, seriously, what is this place?
This is heaven.
Hungry gong, a hinging on, a digging on, a squash banana, hungry.
I was surprised to see that a woman like that was real into me.
Hey, no, don't do that, don't do that.
Catch a flight, change the weather. I promise forever.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Better bitches, better money, my clothes better, my shoes better, I work harder. Fuck Lil Caesars, fuck yep.
Hey guys, so today so I was gonna do a girlfriend haul, but it started glitching.
Movies.
Basically, so I ordered a tall brunette, but I think my order got a little mixed up.
I'm literally taller than you. She's on her tiptoes.
So I actually ordered it not to fucking talk, but I also ordered it to be masked, but it cries every time I leave her house, which is not very mask lesbian of you. I also ordered her to be
I didn't sign the waiver for any of this shit. Send help.
I also ordered it to be a little tanner, but it's okay, I'm not really complaining. See, I also ordered it to have good style, but this is also
this is my pajamas.
Kind of wears every day.
It?
I also ordered it not to be high on perks basically every time I met with her.
It's surgery!
Oh my god. Oh no! So, I also ordered it to be flat, but that didn't really happen. So, that's my girlfriend review. I
2 out of 10
recommend, but I don't know.
Not highly.
It's a little, I don't know, a little gay, but whatever.
reason. No final fantasy, can we end these games? Though you give me energy, make me feel like great. Like a birds of a feather, baby, real life made for each other, and it's hard to keep my cool when other bitches trying to get with my dude. I'm never confused.
I don't want you dating Michael. Why? Do you like him? No, you idiot! I like you!
You love a boy. They say I throw my heart around. And you can be my lover, girl. I'll pick you up, drive you around.
Now wanna be your
be so cold.
Listen to the hit, I got it, popped it.
But I only think of you. Will we be together soon? I see, see.
Beautiful.
Oh, hello.
You know, you belong up here.
So for some reason, no one's talking about this new movie that's coming out, and there's just so much wrong with that. It's called Tar, and I believe that Cate Blanchett is going to be coming in for her 8th Academy Award nomination, and may even secure the Oscar. So it's a psychological thriller about Lydia Tarr, the renowned musician and composer. And the story is going to follow the symphony that takes her career to a whole different level. So the movie actually premiered at the Venice Film Festival, and it received a 6-minute standing ovation. The music is being composed by Hildur Gunnatatir, who recently won the Academy Award for Best Music for Joker, and honestly, Cate Blanchett is reason enough to watch this movie. It comes in at nearly 3 hours long, so it's definitely going to be pulling away from some audiences, but if you're into complex storytelling about destruction of humanity, I feel like this movie is going to be perfect for you.
How much I liked you, but I watch your eyes as she walks by. What a sight for sure.
I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're
your pants up when you're performing. It's incredible.
Belt.
big note to kiss you when nobody's there. The smell of your perfume so stuck in the air. It's hard. Yesterday I thought I saw you shattering around. It's funny how things always change in this one town. So far from the start. And I wanna tell you everything. The words I never got to say the first time around. I remember everything from the word that you would have played in this playground. Just there with you now. As if the whole world was watching, I'd still dance with you. Drive highways and byways to be there with you. Over and over, the only truth. Everything comes back to you. Still make me nervous when you walk in a room. And butterflies, they come alive when I'm next to you. Over and over, the only truth. Everything comes back to you.
O que, que eu ia falar? Eu perdi o ar na mesma hora que eu parei no outro vídeo. É que eu só perdi o ar dessa vez mesmo.
He has elaborate bullshit ideas every 10 seconds. Hey, Teddy, let's doorbell ding dong ditch. You 36!
And I'd be like, why are you so obsessed with me?
She like the fuck me, suck me, suck me, fuck me. I'm the ice cream man. She chunky.
Welcome to Cottage Fest B&B. Are you guys checking in together? Or are you guys just friends? Okay, that's new. Did you want to keep it that way? Do you guys want to sign up for the Friends to Lovers package? Basically, there are a bunch of platonic activities that have romantic undertones, like the game of Twister. And there's also a mock wedding exercise. Well, basically, you guys will watch each other get married to other people to see if, like, you know, you get jealous. I'm going to take this phone call, just stare into each other's eyes for a second. Hello? Yes. Okay, there's a breakup. Okay. Yeah. Lavender Code Black. Send them each a tequila gift basket and a therapist, and then move them to the Casa Amor wing. Sorry about that. If you had to rate the level of tension between each other, what would you say? I'm feeling like a 6. I think we can get that 6 up to a 10 with the Emily Dickens package. So basically, you guys won't see each other the entire time you're here, but you'll write letters to each other, and then right before you leave, you'll have a romantic date. And at the end of your stay, if you want to, like, get married, there's a chapel, like, right there. It's half off with the Emily Dickens package. Preemptively, did you guys want to sign up for couples game night? Basically, whoever packs the U-Haul the fastest gets dinner on the house. What are your signs again? Capricorn and Cancer? Okay. Can you guys kiss really quick? I just want to see what that'd be like. I've seen everything I need to see. I'm actually going to sign you guys up for the I Want to Ruin Our Friendship package. I'm going to put you guys in the Jennifer's Body Suite. Don't worry, the blood is just for ambiance. You're all checked in. Scram. Love ya.
Some kind of light into your darkness. Close your eyes with what's not there.
Y'all, look, I drew cartoons of all the TikTok people that broke up.
First, we have Sedona and Riley. Sedona's literally a frat boy reincarnated, and rumor has it she's still gaslighting to this moment.
I cheated twice, but she got with someone else after we broke up, so I've been crying for 3 days.
Meanwhile, Riley is just like, anyways, back to playing with my crystals. Next, we have Ben and Evan. Ben's like, where the hoes at? But his phone drops book. Meanwhile, Evan is descending into an Olivia Rodrigo phase, which is a sign of declining mental health. But she's up in public approval. And lastly, Avery, Soph, and JoJo Siwa. JoJo is like a millionaire who literally just wants gay friends and to be a normal person for once in her life, but it's actually impossible because she's a walking bedazzled teen. Avery's literally happy-go-lucky psychotic as always, and Soph is diabetic.
Lesbians have me so fucked up on this app. I know more about this situation than I ever intended to, and it's because of you guys. It's because of you guys.
Gassed up, shorty. Said I need my 40. Pull up to the party. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I just wanna be your favorite. I just wanna be your favorite.
Hey, and this is how to make a girl like you when you go on a date. The first step is shut up. Cause hear me out, imagine you're about to go on a date and you're like, okay, I really wanna impress them. And what ends up happening is you end up talking a lot. And you want them to know how smart you are and how funny you are and all these good stories and all these funny things that happen to you, like you spit all that out. And the whole time you're talking about that, they're listening and they're judging, but they're also trying to think of what they're gonna say next. And if you really want them to like you, you want to let them talk, let them try to impress you, let them tell you all the funny stories about themselves and laugh at their funny stories. And guess what? Then they're thinking, oh my God, I think I impressed them. People like people that like them. So by you sitting there and listening and asking follow-up questions and that kind of thing, people think, oh, they must like me, and therefore they like you. This is probably in a psychology book somewhere. I'm not saying you should never talk, but I am saying if you let them have the floor and you ask follow-up questions and you get really interested in their stories, they're gonna leave the date thinking, wow, she was so easy to talk to. She understands me. She appreciated my story. She thought that was funny. They're gonna like you more. Is this manipulation? I don't know. I don't care, but now you.
Oh my God, I didn't expect you here.
You invited me here.
And this is where we'll be sleeping, like, together.
This is really small.
I don't think so. Oh, the cookies are done. I made you my very own recipe. So, like, do you want to play Truth or Dare?
Yeah.
So funny.
I didn't say anything.
So, truth or dare?
Dare.
I dare you to kiss me. Oh my God, I'm kidding. I dare you to tell me who your crush is.
I don't really have one.
Oh, really?
I mean, there's this girl in my lunch named Lexi. She's pretty cute.
Ew, no, don't date her. Let's watch a scary movie.
I'm sorry, I'm just really scared.
So, should I sleep on the couch? No, I made this bed just for us, and plus, my dog sleeps on the couch.
Okay, good night.
Good night.